Today we are going to do our chapter number 6 tissue, and in this video we are going to cover our topic number 2, that is animal tissue. We know that what is tissue now? It is a group of the cells which are having a similar structure and similar function, right? In plants and animals, the group of the cell called tissue, they carry out the specific function. Coming to the animal tissue. To understand the animal tissue, let us take an example. When you breathe in, your chest moves up and down. This movement in the chest is to accommodate the air which is rich in oxygen that we inhale, and then release out the air which is rich in carbon dioxide. This movement is brought about by the muscle cells present in our body. So regular contraction and relaxation of the muscle cells brings about this movement, right? Now when we breathe in, you take in oxygen. This oxygen is transported to the lungs, where it is absorbed and is then carried to all the parts of the body through blood. Blood also carries the food to all the parts of the body. It also collects waste from the various parts of the body and carries them to the liver and the kidneys so that further excretion or purification can take place. Thus, in this example, both muscles and blood are the example of the tissue. Coming to the types of the tissue, right? So we are having, on the basis of their functions performed by them in our body, these are of 4 types. One is epithelial tissue, the second one is muscular tissue, third one is connective tissue, fourth one is nervous tissue. Here we have taken a simple flow chart. So you can see, first is the epithelial tissue. Epithelial is the simplest and the protective tissue covering most organs and body cavities. That is epithelial tissue, which is protective and covering the most organs present in our body. The second one is a muscular tissue. The tissue that brings about the movement in our body is termed as muscular tissue. The third one is the connective tissue. As the name suggests, this tissue helps in binding and supporting the various tissues. The fourth one is the nervous tissue. It includes all the kinds of neurons that helps in carrying the information from your one part or from your sense organs to the brain, and then brain to again back to the sense organs, right? Now coming to the further sub-classification of the tissues. Epithelial tissue is further subdivided into 4 types. First one is the squamous epithelial. Squamous epithelial are those in which the cells are having square-like shape. In case of columnar, the cells are column-like, means pillar-like cells are present. These are arranged in the form of pillars, long columnar-type cells are there. In case of cuboidal epithelial tissue, the shape of the cell is cube-like. As the name suggests, cuboidal, cube-like structure is there. Glandular, which possesses certain glands. As you can say, your skin possesses certain sweat glands, which is going to produce sweat. So this is the example of the subtype of the epithelial tissue. Coming to the muscular tissue, muscular tissue is subdivided into 3. First is the striated one. Striated one are those which are having the light and dark bands. These light and dark bands are due to the presence of proteins, that is actin and myosin. These are also termed as involuntary muscles. These are also known as voluntary muscles because they are directly attached to the skeletal of your body. If we are talking about the unstriated muscles, these are do not have a light and dark bands present, and these are also termed as involuntary muscles. The third one is the cardiac muscle. These are the muscles of the heart. These are also involuntary muscles. We are talking about connective tissue, blood. First of all, blood that helps in connecting our body from one part to the another part, like we are having RBCs, red blood cell, WBCs, white blood cells and platelets. The second one is the bones. Third one is the ligaments, then tendons, cartilage, areolar tissue and adipose tissue. All are the examples or subtypes of the connective tissue. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the epithelial tissue. As I have told you, it is a covering and the protective tissue present in animals, right? So it is a most outermost covering and protective tissue in case of animals. It is present in the outer covering like skin, the outer covering of our organs, the inner lining of your blood vessels, lungs, esophagus, right? So all is composed of epithelial tissue. Squamous epithelial tissue, which consists of a layer of a thin flat cells, and these are present in blood vessels, lungs, mouth, and then esophagus, which is a food pipe. We're talking about the columnar epithelial tissue. These are consist of a tall pillar like cells, and they also possesses hair like projection called cilia. In that case, they are known as ciliated epithelial tissue. Right, so this tissue is known as ciliated columnar epithelial tissue because there possesses the hair-like projection cilia on its surface. The third one is the cuboidal epithelium tissue. These are having a cube-like structure, and these are present in the lining of the kidneys, tubules, ducts of the salivary glands. The fourth one is the glandular tissue. These secrete certain substances and they possesses the glands, which is known as glandular epithelial tissue, right? The next one, we are having this slide. So this is the diagram of squamous epithelium, in which there is a thin flat cells are there. This is a simple tissue. Columnar, here you can see a column like or pillar like cells are there, right? In case of this glandular, there is a gland present in the surface, right? The second one we are going to discuss about the muscular tissue. This tissue helps in the movement in our body, right? This consists of elongated cells, which are known as muscle fibers, and it also contains a protein which is known as contractile protein, which contracts and relaxes and helps in our movements. These muscles, which can move under our will, these are known as voluntary muscles, and the muscles which do not move under our will, they are known as involuntary muscles. So muscles are of two types: voluntary muscles, which are under our control, and second one is the involuntary muscles, which are not under our control, right? So on the basis of the various things, these are of three types: striated muscles, unstriated muscle, and cardiac muscles. This is the diagrams of the muscles: skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles, and this one. I have taken one difference between that so that you are able to understand the characteristics as well as the differences between the three. So coming to the striated, these are the long, cylindrical, and unbranched. In case of striated muscles, unstriated are the long with the tapering ends. Their ends are closed. These cells are non-tapering in case of cardiac muscles. Here in case of striated muscles, many nucleus are present. Here only one nucleus is present in case of unstriated. And cardiac muscle, each cell contains one or two nucleus, which is situated in the center. Now, why these names are called striated muscle? These striated muscles are called because they are having a dark and light bands present, right? Unstriated because these strips are absent here. Here, light and dark bands are not present. In case of cardiac muscle, these are having a faint striations, means these bands are present, but they are very much faint. These are voluntary muscles. Striated one are the voluntary muscles because they are under the control. These are involuntary. This is also involuntary, right? Coming to this one, I'm not able to move it, right? Coming to the examples of the striated muscle, these are the hands, legs, and the other skeletal muscle. These comes under the striated muscles. Unstriated muscles are present in the stomach wall, intestine, your ureter, and bronchi. And cardiac muscles, these are present in heart. Now coming to the connective tissue. Connective tissue, which connects and joins the different parts of the body together, that is termed as connective tissue. First of all, we are going to discuss about the blood. Blood contains a fluid matrix, which is known as plasma, in which three types of cells are present, namely red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets, right? This blood helps in transport of the gases, our digested food and hormones and waste material with the help of heart, right? The second one we are going to discuss about the bone. A bone is a hard and a strong tissue. It consists of cells which are embedded in a hard matrix, and this hard matrix is composed of calcium and phosphorus. The third one we are going to discuss about the ligaments, which are the flexible tissues which joins bones together and then helps in the movement, right? They are the flexible tissues which joins the bones together. Two bones are joined together with the help of ligaments. Tendons, these are the fibrous tissue which are helps in joining the muscle to the bone, right? A bone is attached to the muscle with the help of tendons. These are the areolar tissue and the adipose tissue. Areolar tissue, it fills the space between the skin and the muscles, right? There is a space between the skin and the muscle which is filled by the areolar tissue. Inside the organs also, around the blood vessels, it helps to repair the tissues. That is a function of the areolar tissue. It also provides the cushion-like structure, you can say, which will protect your body against the mechanical shocks. The last one is the adipose tissue. It is mostly found below the skin and between the internal organs, and it contains the fat that helps to store fats, right? So here you can see a ligament. A ligament function is to bind bone to the bone. Our two bones are joined together with the help of ligaments, and tendon helps to bind muscle to the bone, right? So here is a difference between cartilage, tendon and the ligaments. You can see a cartilage is a tough, tendons attaches bone to the muscle, ligaments attaches bone to bone. Here it is present at the end of the bone. Tendons, these are non-elastic, and ligaments are stabilized. Coming to the next one, that is nervous tissue. This is our last type of the animal tissue. So you can see here, nervous tissue which are helps to carry the messages, right? They are going to carry the messages from one part of the body to the other and respond to the stimuli. Now, what is stimuli? This is the any change which is occurring in the environment. It can be in the form of temperature, like heat, cold, whatever the changes is there, right? Light intensity, we are able to see with the help of our eyes, we are able to smell with the help of our nose, right? So we are having a five sense organ which are going to receive that information, right? That information is stimuli, right? So it consists of a nerve cell which are known as neurons. Now coming to the structure of the neuron, right? It is having a cell body. This complete is known as cell body, which is composed of dendrites and this nucleus. This nucleus and dendrite, that is forming a cell body, and this long branch like structure, it is known as axon, right? And if the another neuron is present here, then the junction between the two neuron, means the gap between two neuron, is termed as synapse. So it is known as synapse because we are talking about the neurons. Our body is having a millions of neurons. One information is going to one neuron, then it will pass that same information to the second neuron, and further there is a chain that will lead information to your brain. So the junction or the gap between the two neurons is termed as synapse, and this synapse is filled with the chemical which is known as acetylcholine, right? So here is the end of the chapter. Now I suggest you to read whole topic from the notes provided to you, as well as you can see that YouTube link also which is provided to you, and lastly you are going to read your NCERT topic. Thank you so much.